My dear brothers and sisters, we know that beliefs have no proof, and if there is clear proof, then that would become the truth. I have told you earlier that the aliens were taking away the activated human mind since the Stone Age. I told it based on my 15 years of subtle world inquiry, but not based on the experiences we get when we do meditations. Some of those subtle experiences humans got at the time of the different types of meditations were later turned into different religions and sects. Thus, due to the difference of subtle experience, the religions were born with their own claims. And those claims have been, we are right, but all others are wrong. This shows that those subtle experiences they got were automatic, and there nobody tried to inquire about secret truth which lies deep in the subtle world. What we get free from the shop cannot be the mango. But when we ask for the mango, we will surely get the exact mango that we meant. In fact, religions fight one another owing to their contradicting private exclusive subtle experiences or revelations. I have told you about all those things already. But in this episode, I am giving many proofs regarding the existence of aliens' subtle secret sorcery system. Some asked for a collection of proofs together in a single episode. So here I am doing my duty as well. First, let us try to know something about this topic briefly. Later, we will discuss the proofs. When the world is suffering from the fanatic people of different religions, I hope subtle secret truths which I got from my 15 years of subtle world discovery would reduce fanatic hatred and destructions to an extent. Unlike beliefs, the truth got a special power. Once we knew the truth, then onwards, we can't change it forever. Earlier, people believed that the earth was flat. But after the discovery of spherical earth, the old flat earth belief didn't appear again. And it will not appear again in the future as well. When the light of truth comes, the darkness of belief should go. That means, if we want to call something a truth, it must have solid proof. Mere statements are mere beliefs. We have so many religions, sects, philosophies, etc. All are different. But different answers cannot find out that one and only truth. Thus, all religions become mere different views. If a philosophy causes problems to anybody, that is not at all a philosophy. Unfortunately, everywhere we see religions fight. In fact, the idea, let us live better and let others too live better, must be the background of any philosophy or religion. Only this broad approach can bring permanent peace to this planet. I have told you more about the reasons and methods of alien secret sorcery in previous videos. And those who are interested can watch them as well. Now, let us go to the proofs. First one. Every religion or sect argue that it speaks the ultimate truth. But unfortunately, they say all others are false religions and false gods as well. Also, they argue that other religions are incapable of helping humans to go to heaven. Again, religions claim peace in their religions, but they destroy the peace in the name of religion itself. They all fight for that one God and for his words. This is so silly and childish. Even grown-up children can't do such a foolish act. Now, Don't we see a senseless, uncontrollable force within every religion? In fact, this senseless negative force from behind is called the secret ancient sorcery system of aliens. Next, when we glorify the Creator God, all humans must have united under that Father concept, because all humans are His children. This means, in His name, human divisions are irreligious, sinful, and impossible. Unfortunately, in the name of the Creator God, we have seen only divisions on this planet. Not only divisions, but also we see hatred and bloodshed among the children of that only one God. Is God a sadist? If not, what is the force which causes these terrible things in the name of Creator or Father God? No doubt, everything is controlled by that secret sorcery system. Next, police spy and inquire about the case and finally discovers the secret truth behind it. They do inquiry not based on their childhood beliefs. On the other hand, religions claim their truths based on mere meditations, subtle automatic experiences without inquiries. Here, the very important point is that without inquiry, secret cannot be revealed. But religions didn't do that. So, the subtle experiences that they got are mere beliefs, and they cannot be called truths. Religions use the term God inquiry, but they sit for some type of spiritual practice and finally receive some automatic subtle experience. There they declare it as the ultimate reality or truth. Nobody spied in the subtle world. So naturally, nobody found aliens' secret sorcery that controls every religion and every human from above. Next, every religion says that God is kind and benevolent. Yes, that is right. Unfortunately, religions teach the story God's testing. They say that God tests His children by giving terrible hardship, pain, death, etc. Can a kind God do such terrible acts? Can a mega rich man simultaneously be a very poor person? This shows a big contradiction, isn't it? Now we have the answer to this question. The answer is the secret ancient sorcery system of aliens. Please don't teach kindness as cruelty, and that teaching has done enough violence on this planet already. Next, religions claim that their religions are created for peace. We know that every religion has been further divided into sects. Besides, those further divisions developed hatred and fought terribly within themselves. Please note the point that they fought within the same religion. When they hate and kill within the same religion, naturally, the basic slogan, "Our religion is for peace," becomes nonsense and a lie. Let us see another point regarding the same point. We know that after the death of religious founders, every religion got divided into many sects. Was this the will of both founders and their respective gods? Had they meant those divisions in their religions from above? If the answer is no, then which is the will that worked to create those warring sects? This hints that all human divisions so far created were done by aliens with the help of their own secret and subtlest ancient sorcery system. Next, why did a character of Satan enter the religions? Religions argue that without God's will, nothing would happen. So Satan came according to God's will. Religious scholars even argue that all good and bad come from God Himself. What a contradiction this is! A kind God, but in a sadist's role, playing with the human miseries and human killings. Yet He sends His incarnations or prophets to uplift humans on this planet. Really, this bad side of God is a terrible and foolish notion. Divine hatred and holy killings are the products of such negative religious notions. Belief can make humans believe any nonsense because belief is always blind without the eyes of logic. Unfortunately, all human beings have been fooled by those aliens since the earliest inhabitants of this planet. Thousands of God stories are there in this world. All are different, but every single religion claims its story as the only true God story. Fishing in troubled water is the method of that secret ancient sorcery system. According to religions, one person becomes bad if he prays towards east, and another person is bad because he turns west while praying. Please note here that humans' good qualities are not considered for the judgment. Instead, different directions or rituals do the job of judgment about the good and bad personalities. Shockingly, rituals are considered more important than the essential part, truth and love, in every religion. Oh, humans have been misled by aliens completely. Next. Two small children of a woman fight each other by holding their same mother, saying, "Don't touch my mother, don't touch my mother." In the same way, religious scholars debate and fight for the mere name of the Creator God or for His words. Besides, some of those religious scholars support and train for producing hatred and violence. Just think that how those peacemakers brought down to such a state of peace killers. This is called alien brainwash. And every religion, region, family, individual, etc. are affected totally by this big brainwash. This is also called fate. Alien sorcery counts everything in totality. Some families may be very cruel, and some other families may indulge in immoral sex. But in the far future, everybody in every family will get both equally. This is happening and will happen in all areas of human life, and it includes even the fate of rulers, dynasties, politics, religions, and conditions of the countries as well. There is no escape way, so please awake and work for uniting human beings in the name of kind God and His peace religions, for your sake, your family's sake, and for the sake of your society, nation, and world. Next, I have said about the aliens activated human mind theft. I have told you that they, with the help of their instrument, so-called secret ancient sorcery, have been taking away intensified human mind, like cruel mind, and immoral or perverted sex minds to their world since the Stone Age. Now, please compare my words with the cruelty and immoral sex increased today's world. Next, these lose pure love and honesty if God idea is destroyed. Since these derive the great qualities like honesty and love from God concept itself. Using this idea, aliens have created another trap. That trap is not to consider other religions Creator God or any other god. They make humans to hate other religions' god or gods and make them call those gods as evil forces. Besides, they brainwash humans to destroy other religions' shrines and idols. When people destroy other religions' shrines and idols, at that time, the secret ancient sorcery gets the strong mind of killing one's own god in other religions. This god-hating or god-killing fanatic human minds are later used to increase the cruelty level of that society. This means the result is that the respective societies turn into crueler and more immoral when time passes. Poor human beings, without knowing these secrets, they are continuing the traditional self-destructive activities. Remember, if you argue that we are not believing in other religions' god or gods, as far as that secret sorcery is concerned, it is a futile argument and no use. Here, one more point will help you to know this better. In most of the religions, cruel wars have been fought with shouting their gods' names. This has been a terrible mistake. We should not have used God's name in a war or at the time of killing human beings. In fact, when we help somebody or save human life, at that time we should have shouted in that way. But nobody shouted there. Totally, everything is gone, my dear brothers and sisters. Everything is gone long before. Due to the long, terrible belief brainwash, for many thousands of years, all human heads have lost and have become mere zeros. Man can make many things with science independently, but terrifyingly, in his inner and subtle personality, nowhere he can use his own independent thought. Both religion and science are used according to the aliens' secret sorcery fate decisions. Be very careful, otherwise a world would start a third world war. So, let all of us learn to become harmless. Next, if all these had united in the name of Creator God, this world would have enjoyed an uninterrupted golden age of peace and prosperity. Instead, in some ways, people are waiting for an auspicious time in future to receive that golden age. This totally dismantled the human effort to create unity among people. Instead, it supported caste divisions with the horrible stand like, we are upper caste people, so we are superior, you are lower caste people, so you are untouchable. Look at the contradiction. Religious book speaks about world family, but in daily life, people look down on lower caste people. Further divisions and subdivisions occurred, and the aliens made their maximum. Unfortunately, most of the upper caste people still consider every such human division as a god revelation. Here we see the same brainwash with a different form. Next, similarly, another treachery of aliens is visible within the religions. This is a big joke. Still, it is considered a great God revelation. In every religion, people believe that only their religion would spread the whole world in the end, and all other religions would destroy. Even such an imagination needs a mountain of cruelty. But still, such ideas are secretly nourished within the peace religions. Oh, how terrible contradiction this is. Every religion claims God-given peace in it. So, all religions are the representatives of peace. But they are secretly planning to kill all other religions' peace. This clearly means that every religion is preparing for the destruction of its own God-given peace by destroying other religions. What is this? Please see the terrible cruelty brainwash of the aliens' secret sorcery. By doing this, the evil sorcery intends every human to come to violence with this poisonous idea. In wars, army fight is limited and it is time bound, but aliens can derive massive cruel human hatred mind and violence mind from the religious clashes and religious wars. Poor humans, they fight one another and have been serving aliens continuously from the beginning. Please mind one thing, that in this race to become the only religion of the world, no one will win in the end. All religions would get terrible wounds due to religious wars and would be reduced to nothingness. A religious world war is worse than a world war. Love is God and love is religion. Love saves humans. It can't kill innocent people. So, God and religion have their primary duty in saving human lives and bringing up kindness in humankind. Please let me have a diversion from the topic here, only to speak a few words about materialists. They say there is nothing in subtle world, and thus they end their side argument very easily. This is because, except dreams, they do not have any type of subtle experience. When this is the condition, there doesn't arise any question of subtle spying. They look only at matter and speak everything based on that. Thus, they too have become a kind of believers. Scientists are looking for many probabilities of aliens, and they are working day and night to find some clues connected to those beings. But materialists are firm and never change their beliefs. Mind is also a kind of matter, and it is like water medium and its creatures, both a medium and its beings. By using subtle concrete technology, they can appear or disappear to human eyes, but they are powerful. In fact, we live in mind bodies until death, because the physical body becomes dead when the mind's existence goes from it. The physical body is a mere effigy that our mind's body carries until death. So, there are no materialists, because to declare at least, I am a materialist, they need mind, mind's knowledge and its subtle personality. Let us come to the topic. Yet another belief that all religions believe that the people would become bad when time passes. Simultaneously, they argue that God has given free will to everybody. This is another big contradiction. Nobody can predict anything once free will is given. Even God cannot predict too. Can God say 2 plus 2 equals 10? No, because truth cannot be altered at all. Similarly, if there is God-given free will, then God must wait to see that person's choice and his life before speaking something about his future. That means, if anybody predicts, it must be some predestined events. And nobody can predict if there is no predestined fate. Thus, it gives a clear picture that everything is predestined by some subtle forces. Anyway, if God does people bad when time passes, then no doubt that injustice cannot make him a God. If the answer is God can't make people bad, then who gets the benefit by making people bad day by day? To this question, today we have got a clear answer. Again, the answer is the same, and it is aliens' secret sorcery system. They have filled such beliefs in all religions and sects from the beginning, only to brainwash people. This made humans sit idly without caring about the degradation of human good quality. If things come this way, only then they get immoral sex mind and cruel mind. Otherwise, they can't get. Besides, this helped them to stop people from spying in the subtle world, just to know the reason for such a steep moral degradation as well. Next, even if people prayed to God, sometimes people's sufferings would not end. At that time, people called such suffering fate. This fate, in other words, is called the haunting of that secret sorcery system. The subtle theories like God's testing, karma, fate, etc. are only the different subtle theories created for answering these helpless human conditions. I have given more explanation about karma, God's testing, etc. on the website. Those who are interested can visit the website. Next, many believe that dead holy people are millions in number. So they believe that they can do something to humans. Belief is only an expectation. In fact, those dead holy people could have changed the quality of people of their respective religions. Instead of that, human beings went horribly cruel and immoral. This shows that secret sorcery alone influences everything on this planet. Next, we know that religions claim peace, but they all support its opposite, the cruel religious wars. How is it possible? In fact, for whom do they do these cruel deeds? Every religion fights for the Father God or Creator God of all religions. Don't you see the exact fooling of secret ancient sorcery here? Next, religions mainly consider rituals as their religions. What is the use of a ritual fence around a religion? Is it not for mere separation? If religions had considered truth and pure love as the basis of religions, could those secret sorcery beings create hatred and bloodshed on this planet? No. Pure love would have swept away all the differences and a permanent golden age would be the result. Now, please think why these ritual fences have been considered by all religions as divine. Next, if there is a creator God, he should have come to this world a million years before at the Stone Age itself. But he came late or started to speak in the very later period. Were all those earlier humans not his creation or children? Did he consider heaven, salvation, etc. only for the latest people of a few thousand years? At last, when he came, at that time a great peace was expected, but terrible hatred, violence and bloodshed increased much more than the previous world. Please think yourselves the reason behind this. Next, even in this modern age, the same barbaric holy wars, holy killings, suicide bombings, etc. being followed blindly in the name of beliefs. In fact, religions should inspire to save human life, but instead, they inspire to kill humans. This is the clear proof of secret sorcery's brainwash work. Next, in the beginning, when humans were living in the forests, in all the different forests of this planet, the forest dwellers used to worship ghosts. How? Who did reveal such worship in their primitive mind? This clearly shows that aliens had connected the human mind with the help of their own secret sorcery system from the beginning itself. There are many other points available, but these set points are enough to realize the existence of the secret ancient sorcery of aliens. I would like to ask that when there are many peaceful ways given in every religion to attain heaven or salvation, why should we use the wrong and horrible methods of violence? So, just to reach belief heaven, please don't make this real earth a hell by creating hatred, violence and bloodshed. And this is my humble request to the people of all religions. My dear brothers and sisters, to inform you about aliens' secret subtle sorcery system and to warn its dangerous outcomes is the purpose of my every word. I have no intention of degrading any religion, sect and god or gods. If bad people misused a small fund, its negative effect would be small. But if they misused a big fund, it would become the curse of society. So let us use the big fund, so-called creator god or father god, in a divine way, so that nobody would claim him within a small religious fence. Children, when they grow up, stop claiming shining sun to their own village. On the other hand, brainwashed beliefs by making humans claim Father God and Heaven only to their respective religions bind humans in logic infancy until their death. Though aliens allowed humans growth in science lately, they never allow growth in family life, social life and religious life at all. So let us start thinking seriously about those three life-sustaining peace, namely peace in family, peace in society and world peace. This serious human movement will change radically the fate of human lives, and no doubt it will bring a great golden age of peace, happiness and prosperity to this planet. Thank you.